Okay, well, somebody around your wife, I guess, has do they know someone who has like goggle glasses and they have black hair? Okay, is there somebody around you, your wife, that has goggle-looking glasses and black hair, short, I guess, kind of messy, and he's a very tall guy? And he follows you around, I guess, or it's somebody that you know? Like it's in.
That could be several people, actually. My Uncle Kent was a Cherokee medicine man and would dream about me and find me clear across the country before the invention of cell phones, just to tell me his dreams. And his dreams were always true. Took him 32 years to name me. But that sounds about like him.
So he
He
just
was the
like,
bear.
okay. Did he used to wear like a headband too, like a hippie headband, but it's like for sweat? You know what I'm saying?
With dual coat facing cobras.
Yeah. And that's kind of weird because it does, because he's like not even Indian looking to me. Is
He never leaves me.
I think
I would.
he's completely like inside of you and carrying you around, and you could just, you can, it's like really weird because I saw you first with your wife, and
Yes.
how you kind of have like blonde roots and you have blue hair or something.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what I saw. But now I'm seeing this guy with you who almost looks like Abraham Lincoln. And he wears goggle glasses, you know what I'm saying? His hair's like Abraham Lincoln's hair, you know what I'm saying? And
John.
do what? It, and he's really tall though, really
That's
big.
my other surrogate Uncle John.
Okay, well that's what I was seeing before I got cut off and had to go.
And my daddy passed 3 months before I was born, and him and Kit and John were the three musketeers, and they were in Germany when my daddy was killed, and they have watched over me their entire lives, and I've recently lost
So
them all.
your dad had really blonde hair, right? Like natural blonde hair, and it was long.
My dad, it was a blondish redhead, yeah.
That's right, and he had long hair, and he was very
Yeah.
big, tall too, and he had like bluish gray eyes too, like
He
you.
looked tall, but he wasn't. He carried himself tall.
Okay, and he was just, you know, what's his astrology sign? Because he seems just stable,
September
relaxed.
14th.
September
September
14th.
was the 14th.
So it might be a Libra or Virgo.
He's been Virgo, yeah.
Virgo, okay. So, So the three musketeers, okay. Well, okay, the other third person, did he have glasses on too? But he was really skinny, he had red hair.
Yeah, they all three was very similar. Kit was just the big one of the bunch.
So the two had the goggle like glasses, but the long-haired guy, which is your dad, didn't, and that's who I thought your dad was.
Yeah, my dad didn't have glasses.
But that's right, he don't have glasses. The only two other two do, like goggle looking glasses, which is weird. And they were both heavier weight or bigger than the skinny guy with the redder hair, you know, the darker hair.
Then the little one, the bear, Uncle Kit, he was my spiritual guide. He's a big guy.
Yeah, they, I was
He
very big. Yeah, he's
was a
very big.
wind talker at the end of Nam.
Okay. And he had like a red headband on, right? That's the first one I saw.
Always.
Yeah, that, oh, really? Oh my gosh, he's so weird. Which is cool though, but I love those headbands, but like it just does not match with him in a way. I don't know why.
Well, and the three of them mixed together on me. I'm not a good communicator until they start yelling at me, and then I can't block them out. But they mix together like they're one soul.
Right, that's what it seems like. They're all being carried around by you. Like they're just living in your dreams and through you or some bullshit. Which is really insane.
I talk to them daily, yeah.
So they're probably there all the
That's so
time.
cool.
Which is insane. But like basically, yeah, your dad is the negotiator or something. Like is the main one, right? He's like the middle boy, but the main one that's with you a lot or something is the one that looks like the Abraham Lincoln, but he doesn't really look like him, but he kind of does in a way.
Because he's recently, he was murdered by his brother at the beginning of this year. He ain't.
Ooh, don't tell me. Maybe I could tell you if he did. Did he get in the axe in the head or something, or did he just use to wear a feather in his head or something crap? I either see a feather in his head or an axe in his head. I'm not sure.
He had a hole through his face.
Oh, yeah?
But, yeah, he isn't settled yet. There's unfinished business, and I'm the last one to finish it. There ain't no one left.
He seems to be very quiet, though. And your dad talks the most. And then the other guy, he's just a follower along. He doesn't really... No,
yeah,
he's just like a kid acting person.
I feel my dad, and I've seen him several times in my life.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't very rarely ever hear him. The only one that I ever really hear loud is Kit.
Is that the redhead, or is it the one that I said that was quiet?
That's the big quiet one.
Okay, yeah, because he's big. It's like he's just out of it all the time, but he's like just... in his own head when he talks, right?
Yes.
And then, like, sometimes it's like your father would appear talking to you, like, with his hands, and then all of a sudden it would just, like, wipe away, like, he felt like it's like, he only has a temporary time with you, and then just fades away. And it was just like a flash. Like, what the fuck, right?
That's exactly it.
Mm-hmm. And he's with the two guys, And then the other one just, like, follows along, like, oh, it's time. And then he shows up before it's too late, you know? Like, the redhead says it's, like, it's time.
Yeah.
Which is so funny. They're, like, three little witches from Hocus Pocus. Little group.
He carries the other two. He always told me he followed the ancestors, and when he left this world, he was going to become the carrier of spirits. And all new spirits would ride upon his back to the haunting ground.
Wow. I mean, we really can kidnap spirits and hold them. But I only try to get their way, go back home wherever the light is or whatever the crap that would even be. Because there's, like, no such thing as anything, it seems like. Just, like, empty space and all this bullshit and a bunch of realms. And where is really home besides in your head? I don't know. Not sure.
In your heart. Home is in the source. It's in everything. It touches everything, and it's contained in everything.
Yeah. I just see the spirits. They go in the light, and they come back out. In and out of the light is all I see, and I don't know. And your best friend is like your home. The one who has all your information. I don't know.
The best friend that has all my information?
I guess. Just for people. I don't know. Whoever the fuck. Whatever. And... oh, well, let's see. You want to question me? Ask me something. Maybe I'll pick up.
Do you feel any female connection?
Okay, so do you have a sister, or is she a Libra too?
I had a close friend.
And she has red hair. She has, like, a dyed red hair. It's not red, but it's, like, a brownish burgundy colored hair, and her eyes are really pretty, and she's kind of heavyweight, and she's very short, and she says, I'm a Libra, or is she just admiring that you're a Libra, cuss, Virgo? Is she a Libra? She has, like, a lazy eye, but, like, they're just, like, you know, pretty eyes, really pretty. She looks like a Sagittarius or something.
Pretty and crazy behind them.
Yeah, that's right, that's what she looks like, and she has beautiful hair. She's beautiful, long, straight, reddish, burgundy hair. That's what it is. Reddish, burgundy, brown hair, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and she's kind of heavyweight, and that's fine. And she has these really pretty freaking eyes, like, with crazy in them, like you said. Yes. So I see her just kind of dancing with you, like, you're a Libra. Like, she's just being sarcastic. Like, she just... do what?
I need to know if she's a
thief. I don't know. I just see her in your life, and I'm not sure where they all are. They're just with you, and that's what it is. She just kind of like comes up to you and be like, I'm a Libra, or you're a Libra. Do you even know when her birthday is, or you don't know?
She was a funny sort. She was surprised that she had many shades of herself. Her soul is recycled many times.
Well, that sounds cool. Interesting, I guess. I don't know. Let's see.
We left this world in a horrible way, and it left a scar on our group of friends, and she was the glue.
Did she die? Did she just die of like a heart problem or something like that?
Well, you know, it was a very violent death, but yeah, it did have to do with her heart.
But like, she lived through whatever she went through, and then she died of something that crushed her heart. Like, they tried to put her heart together, and it just didn't last, right?
That may have happened. It was her husband, and he's at the mental institute for the rest of his life.
Hmm.
And it involved two infants, one unborn and one infant. A very, very, very sad, violent situation.
Yeah.
I got there 10 minutes too late for vengeance.
Aww. Did it have to do with a car, too, like, chasing around, being chased or whatever? Like, kidnapped kind of thing?
Well, yeah, I'm sure that would be a definite emotion.
Did he make her steal and stuff?
He would make her do things. She was a prisoner in her own freedom.
Basically. And she got to do everything that he told her to do.
He was very
and even with her kids, like, she didn't she have like a daughter or something, and did they kill the daughter or something, the baby?
Yeah.
And then she had a son. She had a son.
With a sword.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
And then went into his mom's house next door and got their 1-year-old son.
The son. That's right. The son. Yeah.
Yeah. And then cut the unborn baby out of her belly.
Yes, I see that too. I saw that too. And I thought, but I didn't say anything because that's like a lot of extremeness.
Yeah, it's
and but that he made her, after he did that, he made her try to drive that dead baby to the dumpster somewhere or something to get rid of it.
Is it? And it was kept hush.
Hmm.
I got told I needed to be there, and
okay.
I got up, and then about that time, people came to say, hey, we gotta go, something's wrong with Mary, and the cops got to 10 minutes before I did.
Okay, gotta click this off, okay? So she has, like, a dark turquoise necklace, too? Is that what she used to wear, too?
The dragon.
It was a dragon? Is it a dark blue turquoise thing, or what?
A silver dragon with a turquoise center.
Okay, it was a silver dragon with a turquoise center. I saw a scene. And, she had a hippie headband, too, before, too. I love those things. Right? Huh?
Yes.
Yes. And, she's into incense and all that unpollution bullshit. But, either way, she's cool. Answers. Did she think that she communicates with wolves or something like that?
She played with animals.
She played with animals.
She was definitely spiritually connected to the canine breed.
Okay. That's interesting. Oh, are you still there?
Yeah, we're still here.
Okay, because everything's going in and out.
So,
I'm trying to see if she's got anything to say.
Around another medium, things I can't hear start coming into focus, and I start hearing things in the back. I can't focus on them unless I need someone else to conduit.
Yeah, I just see the son that they killed or something like that, and the daughter, and they're still around that girl. Well, I don't know. I just see them around her still. I don't know. Like the little boy had dark brown hair, and the little girl had reddish strawberry blonde hair, right?
The little boy for sure. I don't know about the little girl. She was unborn.
Okay.
She was still in womb.
But wouldn't she be like 14 year olds right now? Wouldn't she be like 14 right now or something? 17? Somewhere
nine.
Around? She'd be 9?
Nine.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Looks like she's bigger than that. I don't know.
I spent 25 years on a carnival also.
Yeah, that sounds fun.
And
terrible. Traveling everywhere in smoke.
A lot of spirits just followed me from there too.
Right.
Some of them I don't.
Did you hear about the fireball that one guy died? He was only 18 years old. On the fireball ride, the new ride, this year.
At Six Flags.
No, at the fair, the fair itself, the state fair.
Oh, it's there. No, I hadn't heard about that.
Yeah, there was like 8 injured or something like that. Well, okay. Let's see.
I've seen some things and jumped to action. Never had to see any customers die, but I've seen some fatalities on the cruise side.
Did that girl talk about Casper? She says, "I'm Casper now."
That would be her. That would sound like something she would say.
She says, "I'm Casper now," and she like has her hands out like. Yeah, she's all sarcastic, and she's like, "I'm a Libra, I'm Casper." She's just like, "I'm this, I'm the."
Her favorite thing was someone to get the ticket on her, and she'd say, "Look, I'm just gonna stick my thumb in your eye and be done with it, and be giggling the whole time."
Right.
And she was the first person I had come out to, as far as any feminine feelings. I overcompensated most of my young life because being abused when I was too weak to defend myself.
Hmm.
And then I overcompensated, so I got really huge working in the steel industry. And she was the first person that gave me any female clothes that, you know, I didn't steal from a clothesline.
Hi. Right, right. Yeah, she gave you like, did she give you like a vest, but it actually was that guy's vest?
Yeah,
it was a guy's vest, but, and then like, you were wearing a blue shirt underneath it or something like that, and she gave you her blue shirt or something like that?
Silk.
It was a silky blue shirt? Like a...
I got it upstairs. In fact, it's right above my head right now in the rafters.
And...
In a box, put away.
She's just real cool, I guess, yeah. And she had scarves, but she wore them around her waist. Is that how she dressed?
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes.
Yeah, she was very
dreams.
Very kissy.
Yes, I love it. She's so pretty. And she would wear, like, high heel shoes with her feet showing, kind of. Like, you could see the cleavage of her toes, and they were, like, high heels. Is that how she dressed?
Yeah.
And they're pointy, at the point. Is that how she
dressed me up one year for Halloween. We went out, and, we dressed up. She dressed me up as a hooker, and she dressed me
Yeah, did you have, like, did you have an eyebrow piercing?
Yeah, she did.
No, did you? I thought you did. One of y'all did.
Yes, I do.
Okay, you did. Okay. That's what I thought I saw. You had an eyebrow piercing. And you had dark hair back then. Your hair was black and a little blonde streak in the front of the bangs, right?
Yeah, that's about right.
You had a blonde streak and everything else was black.
It wasn't chemically bleached. It was sun bleached.
Okay, and you painted your nails blue and red glitter or something like that, right?
Yep. And I got more numbers than she did.
Yeah.
She was so mad at
And
me.
you had a pillowcase. Y'all both had like white pillowcases and a green one or something like that.
Yeah, that someone made us with pot, that is white with pot leaves sewn on them.
Right. And y'all would laugh at everything every time you'd get candy and stuff like that. And then this
Yeah.
guy F was following y'all around, y'all met, and he had black hair and he had a vest on and he was skinny and he had those goggle glasses on. I have no clue. What?
Yep. He was there when she was killed. He didn't save her, and he could have.
Yeah, he didn't do anything. He's very progressive, not aggressive, you know what I'm saying? Like,
Yeah,
but
he
he's
just got picked
tall.
up by the federal marshal for being a pedophile just recently.
That's terrible.
Yeah, he's a horrible, horrible person that I kept close to me for a long time.
Yeah, he's a very quiet person.
Yeah, he was spiritually destructive also.
Do you know when he was born? Cancer sign? He's like
Let's
a
see, I believe. Yeah, what I
July.
do, I've got his dog tags here somewhere.
Is he? I bet you he's born in like July or August or something. Could
Yeah, it
be.
seems like it was warm weather. I would say it's late 70s because he was a little bit older than me, and I was born in 80.
And he was gay or bisexual or something too, right?
He was bi. He always denied it, but yeah, he
Yeah, he
was.
always denied it. Yeah. He do acted like he was straight. He didn't know, and but he was secretly just wanting to fuck or something, probably. He had perverted intentions.
And like little boys.
Right, that's so retarded. That's weird that most cancer signs are the criminals that are child molesters, and I've met a lot of those people like that, and even Leos are like that I met. Ugh. And I met
I don't
Sagittarius.
understand it, but there's a lot of things in the world that you can't.
Yeah,
I
it's just
studied the.
ridiculous.
Yeah, I
Everyone's a
studied
psycho, everyone's a
psychology and
cunt.
sociology.
Everything's a
So,
fucking asshole.
history's always been interesting, anyways.
Okay, well, let's just
Interesting
see who we
term.
can contact and actually have a conversation with. That'd be so cool. Oh, okay. Okay, well, also, doesn't that girl who we're talking about, say that she's a gypsy and she has an angel around her? Did she ever say
Yeah,
that? My angel this and my
my
angel
mom's
that. Is that what
trained.
she says? She, like, pretends to talk for an angel. And I guess she does have an angel around her, but she, like, pretends to talk for her or something like that, right?
Yep, the angel's name is Carol.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, all angels always look the same. Blonde hair, blue eyes. But some have brown hair and blue eyes, I've seen. So she's just flown around on her left side, it seems. And then, did she ever mention that, though? That my angel's floating around me on my left side, and because just to balance my right side, because my right side's so heavy that my left side needs to be balanced. Do what? The imp?
There's an imp with her.
Okay.
She always called it her imp. It's a troublemaker.
Okay, hold on, I'm gonna minutes. Okay, say that now. What'd you say?
She always carried an angel on one side and the devil on the other, but she didn't call it the devil. She said it was her imp.
Okay, so that's what she said. She said something out loud about that, right? I was being specific,
Right.
kind of, but I was talking about how she said that, how she would say it. So I'm getting contact with her, but it's like off and on, and you're talking a lot, which I still like talking, but I don't know. But when you talk, it inserts more things too, which is weird.
Well, I'm a funnel.
Which is, that's just what happens. I understand that too. A vortex. Everyone's a little vortex.
Oh,
A little
yeah.
portal.
I can drive through towns and know how the whole town feels.
Yeah. And what is your strongest? Oh, yeah, your Virgo, cusp, Libra. I keep on freaking forgetting that. Okay, We should do your birth chart too and see what that's like, I guess. In a minute, after
Okay.
I see if I can see anybody else. Ow, you're biting me. My dog's biting me.
What kind of dog is it?
She's a Shih Tzu poodle. And she's a Gemini, Aries rising, Moon Aquarius, with Venus conjunct Mars, Uranus in the first house, or something like that. Yeah, something like that. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna continue with you. You want to tell me more? Cause I'm still. What do y'all? You both y'all can do it at the same time. I want to see if I can pick up on both y'all. Cause I contacted them off and on, those people. That's a crowd around him or your wife, but I just don't know. I'm losing it. I want to see if I can contact back with you, the Scorpio, for a little bit too. I don't know what where to begin or end. I don't want to end, but I want to get in contact so I can stay contact instead of go back to different subjects, which is fine. I do that a lot. I scatter everywhere.
Right, and there's so many of them around us, and they all want to say something.
They can, but they're just acting like it's nonchalant, and I'm like, please say something fucking abnormal or something like way off the,
And that's kept me disconnected for a while because I haven't been able to. I've been spiritually disconnected for quite some time due to
And
chaos.
she would draw on her face, all over her face too, like with dots and swirls and stuff, like Hindu looking art. Like henna, and she had a big giant bow in her hair, like a big giant 80s bow in her hair too, at one time.
At one time.
Yeah, I see that big giant red bow. That's really cool. Like a Madonna's bow.
It was off of a teddy bear that I gave her.
Yeah. That's interesting. Did you give her a giant brown teddy bear? Is that what I'm
Here,
saying? It was a
I bought it back from the carnival. She wanted a 5-foot teddy bear, and I brought
She
her one.
wanted, she got her a white one, but you got her the brown, she kept the brown one, right?
Yeah, it was a little off color. I don't quite remember.
Okay, well, and she's like, he's asleep, like somebody was asleep on the teddy bear at the fair or something. So they
Yeah,
didn't.
it was my bed.
Oh, okay.
I slept in the back of the joint trailer and on top of the stock, and it was my bed, and it had gotten ripped, so it was given to me, and I fixed it and brought it back and gave it to her.
Aw. Okay, let's see. Well, those are some nice memories y'all all have together that still lives till to be seen by psychics and people around your environment. How sweet as fuck is that, right?
Right?
Isn't that so nice? What an impact. Is that your mom?
Yeah.
'Cause I saw her and she's short just like you too, right? And she's skinny like you, but she's littler than you in a way. And her hair is short too, just like your, but her hair is more straight or something and shorter, a little bit shorter.
No.
Oh, well, I'm confused. It's a darker red hair, right? Oh, it's curly. Okay. I thought it was straighter. Oh, but she did cut it off and make it straight before, right? And then it became whatever you said, long.
Well,
So that's why I was
yeah.
just seeing the period of time where it was really short and straight at one time. And she was drinking alcohol, I guess. Her breath smelled like alcohol. I don't know. But she was alive too and has a ring on her finger, a big ring on her finger that you point at, and she wear a vest, like a denim vest or something like that, you know what I'm saying? And she owned some kind of trailer or something, or a store, like a hair salon or a hair product store or something, like a dollar store. Did she work at a dollar store or a hair store or something like that?
When we went to Sally's.
Oh, you went to Sally's, so she acts like she works there and getting professional stuff done or something.
Yeah, because she thought she owned the place.
And that's how she acts, yeah. It's so funny. Yeah, she does. That's cool. And she has brown eyes too, right?
Depending on her mood,
that's
her
true.
Eyes change from green to blue to brown to...
They do look like they change. And she had, like, a busted vessel in her eye too, like a red...
Yep.
Vein, blessed vein in her eye is what I'm seeing. So I am picking up on her, obviously. She smokes cigarettes, right?
Yep.
And drinks. And, yep. Where's that ring on her pointed finger, right?
Yes.
That's what she's wearing. It's a really pretty ring. Like, it's a green and opal bluish ring with silver. Is that right?
I know exactly what ring you're talking about.
It's so pretty. I want it. Wasn't that store right next to a restaurant, too? Like a pizza place or something?
Yes, there was.
You eat pizza, macaroni and pizza, all kinds of pizza. And it's inside. You can sit down and inside of it, right?
Yep.
That's so funny, because we have the same thing here, too. Nathan, Keithan, does she know a guy named Nathan or Keithan or something like that? She's saying those words. I have no clue. Keithan, Nathan, I don't know.
Keithan. Passed away, my son was in the bed with her and his name is Kate.
Wow, yes. She was saying that. That's what it sounded like. And that's so cool. I'm doing it.
You've got a great gift.
Yeah, I'm doing it.
Within the first few minutes of watching you the other night, I said, yeah, he's real and I'm not a naysayer, but I am drawn to point out and expose faith.
Did you cut your hand and you had to wrap it or something? Your right hand?
Yeah, a sword went through it while I was sensing.
And it's like that now or not? Because I just see your right hand being cut like a sword, of course, and now there's a wrap over it. So high five to you. Isn't that funny? Oh no, like your ring finger and your middle finger and your, I don't know what else finger, but it seems like you can still feel your pointed finger, but it's swollen, right?
Yeah.
So it's like basically these two fingers, the middle finger and then the wing finger is very numb.
And the corner
of the pointy finger kind of is, like half, like on the tip and at the bottom, but in the middle you can still feel it, right?
Because I can only half feel it.
That's specific, ain't it? That's the shizzle.
Yeah, you've got a gift, I love it.
It's a talent. It's just anybody can do it. Everyone has it. Everyone has it. Everyone can do it.
Not everyone can connect to it, though.
Not everyone wants to because they're assholes.
Well, they're
scared of it.
It's a social experience, an experiment. Everyone needs to freaking do it. Everyone who's trusted and has a good heart could just needs to be devil to just do it. And just do it. Okay, well, I'm going to turn this off for a second. Okay, I'm seeing someone who I thought would be your son, but I figured you really didn't have a biological son. But I didn't want to mention that, and you just said that there was somebody in the background, which is, you call your son, right? And I said to you, yeah, and I said to you, he has blue eyes and blonde short hair, right? Like a shaved head that's got blonde hair, natural blonde.
Oh, that is my baby brother. You're talking about my baby brother.
Okay, and he's a little kid. And something about his mother might have I don't know if it's his mother, something about his mother, taken away from his mother. I don't know. And she has glasses on, and she smokes cigarettes. Ew. And she has, like, reddish hair, dark red hair. And she's short.
That was, maybe it might be where I was taken away from our mother.
Yeah, did I say that? Like, taken away from the mother? And something about... Did they try to say that she's dead? Did they try to say that she was dead and they can no longer see her? They tried to say that she's dead, and he thought that his mom was dead, and that he wanted to talk to her in spirit and everything, right? But she's really alive, right?
That would be me as a child then.
Okay, that's you, with your blue eyes and blonde hair.
I was young, and all of a sudden this woman come up and said, hey, I'm your mom.
Yeah?
And
she had glasses on, and she smoked cigarettes, and she just acted nonchalant about it. If she did come up to you, acted like a totally different stranger, and you were like,
yeah.
You were like surprised, like, who is that? Like, you got up off the floor or something. You were sitting on the floor, and that's how it was outside on the ground on cement, right?
Outside,
that's right. I'm getting shit. I'm seeing your whole beauty, boo. So that's cool. And then Dustin, who is that? I don't know, me, I don't know, whatever, my name is Dustin. But someone said Dustin or something. Do you know anybody named Dustin? Because someone just said Dustin. I'm like, my name is Dustin, bitch. Do you know what I'm talking about? I'm trying to ask you that question because I don't know if that was, huh? There's like a girl behind me, she goes, Dustin. I'm like, okay, bitch, my name's Dustin. But also, I'm trying to get with you for a minute, see what's going on at the same time. Because, like, big fucking deal, I don't really know yet where to land. And I'm trying.
Bombarded.
I am bombarded, and that's fine. I just want to land somewhere and settle and actually have a communication, wholeheartedly connection with at least one of the spirits or the beings. Whatever the fuck's going on. Unicorns would be so cool. I've never seen a unicorn. I'm just... My dog is biting the fuck.
Like,
do what?
My mother likes unicorns.
The unicorn? Yeah, I think it would be your mom too. Something that has to do with your mama. I want to show you my dog biting the hell out of me. Oh, oh, there she goes. See? She's a biter. She'd bite me. Okay,
Bite her back if you stop that shit.
Right. Well, that's so funny though. I'm not gonna bite her hard, but I don't know. I know, I like to gnaw on her, chew on her. You like? Cool, it's cool. She likes to bite hard though. She just plays rough because she's a Gemini. She likes to chew on everything, and I have so many chew things for her. Like more than that. Here you go.
Okay.
Well, whatever's clever. I'm down with the clowns. So okay, I'm listening to this other girl that goes to church and shit like that. I have no clue why. They're going to church. Oh, they went to church because of the funeral. They were there with whoever at the funeral. Like, y'all all sit in the front on the right side of the row, right? The right side of the row in the church at a funeral?
Yeah, I did.
You did, yeah. And, you were in the middle of everybody, and there was this guy, I think it's your wife, I'm not sure, that was holding you with their left hand. They were on the right side of you, and they were rubbing your back?
No, that's my son's dad, Eric.
Your son's dad, Eric. And he's like, oh man, it's just a shame, or something like that he was saying, right?
Yeah.
And, worms are so cool. Psychic worms. Bait. Well, that's what it was. Then, he... Oh, God. I'm just confused. Okay. Also, when you were outside the funeral, you dropped your mirror when you were putting lipstick on, right? It was like a mirror, lipstick mirror, and you dropped it, and I think it broke a little bit.
Yep.
And you were wearing this red, reddish, fuchsia-ish color lipstick.
Yeah.
That's correct, and you broke it, and you're right in front of, like, some kind of limo car-looking thing, or a hearse, maybe. It was a burgundy car. It was a long, big car. It was that color? Yeah, and you dropped your fucking mirror in your lipstick holder mirror or something. That's what it was, but it broke a little bit. And then you dropped your phone or something. I think you got a phone with an antenna that you can put on, like, raise up and put down, like it was a really old kind of fashion phone, you know what I'm saying? Cell phone?
Underneath.
That's what I'm doing. Using. Okay. I hope your number didn't mention. Okay. Speaker away. I won't mention numbers. I don't know. Oh, I got that out.
Okay.
Do what? Your head hurts too? Isn't that weird? Maybe there's demons around or something because they make people's head hurt and shit. Mm-hmm.
Well, when I'm speaking to someone else, the channels I pick up on it, funnel it too, and I get overwhelmed easily.
Yeah, I was about to throw up because my head was hurting so bad, but it wasn't y'all because I had it before y'all came over in my visions. Okay, well, good talking to you. We'll do this again sometime. Mm-hmm.
Not even have to talk about reading. I just like to converse with you.
Yeah, we do your birth chart too next. Whenever.
Okay.
And we'll record it for evidence. Just because it is.
I'm going to pull a card for you.
Okay. What? Card? Sure. Try it. Cause, yeah. I'm up for anything, any fun experience.
I bring my cards every now and then, and I get pretty decent results.
We can record that session, too, if you want to.
I generally only pull one card.
Okay, it's cool. I'll give it a chance, that's fine.
Right. Well, some things some people need to focus with, and other people don't need to focus.
Mm-hmm. Let's see.
It's just a tool.
So, does your toe, is your toe painted too? And did you hurt your toe? Or did you get your toe cut off or something like that? Do you have also a wrap on your toe? Not your big toe, but your toe next to it?
Yeah, I have a bad toe, but I have foot problems.
Right. You have a wrap on your foot and around your toe next to your big toe. Your big toe has blue with red sparkles on it too or something like that? Or green?
Yeah, it did have anyway, it did.
It did, yeah. And then it, okay.
Rolling.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna cut this off. Ask y'all, I have a crowd of spirits in my womb now, and one of them is, a black guy. He's a big black guy, I don't know. And your mom was saying Keith, and I was just letting you know that. And then there's that, I think that, I'm so confused, the angel that floats around that redhead girl of your wife's, you know, see what I'm saying? So, I don't know, they should hear this bullshit, because I don't know who the black guy is, and I don't know if that's related to you. I don't know. No, he doesn't have white hair, but now I'm seeing him have white hair, and he looks like he's blind, but he has cataracts. That's what he was when he was alive.
I know who that is.
He had cataracts. It looks like he was blind as fuck, right? Because, like, his eyes look so webbed over with blue. that he looks blind, but it's just cataracts when he was alive and his hair was white. But right now, his hair is all black and his skin's all back to dark, caramely youthfulness. And his eyes are back to regular. That's what I'm seeing him as, his younger self. But when you said that, I could see his living self as that old self chapter. Isn't that amazing? And he's a big guy, like the Green Mile guy, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, his name's Homer.
His name's what? Oh my god, he was like sitting right inside of my body almost, like behind me. And then there's this angel girl that's a blur. And then there's your mom right on my left side. And, you know, and there's some couple of god people in my fucking kitchen. And I'm just confused. And I don't really fucking know how to keep everybody at the same thing. I'm so confused. But that's cool. Like, that's the black guy. And he needs to confirm more than just, like, his looks. I want to hear him say something. Did he used to have a box? Like a music box that had a beautiful ballerina on it, because I love those things. I'll take one of those. He had that?
Yes, him and his wife used to babysit.
Oh, I love that music box with the ballerina dancing. You know, it's a music box. It's so cool. I love music boxes. I have music boxes. One of them's broken. Yeah. Yeah, I love music boxes. This one's broken. Honestly. So they can hear that. I said, so they can hear that. My music box is for them. And it was like a red music box, an apple red, and the ballerina. So pretty. Yes, love it. No, this is the part of the music box, though. Also, I want to know about some guy named Trav. I don't know. Do you know about that guy?
Named what?
Trevor, I don't know. He used to. Heath. So his name's Keith. Everyone's talking about Keith. Is he a little... I'm just confused. Why all of them want to say the word Keith? All of them say the word Keith. And I don't know why. I want to know why, because I'm confused. Okay. I'm going to tell... Also, that guy, he... The black dude, he chews on tobacco and spits. Is that true or false?
Yes.
Because that's disgusting. And he said it's better than smoking. And he used to smoke a cigar, though. What a hypocrite, right?
Every now and then.
That's right. So he did smoke cigars, and he does chew tobacco. And he would wear sandals with no socks on, is what I'm seeing. Uh-huh. Is that true? And he would wear a vest too, like a motorcycle looking vest outfit or something like that.
Every once in a while, yes.
Yeah, and a unicorn. Your mother has a piercing above her ear, right? Not just her earlobe, but on the top of her ear, right, too? Like a hoop.
Yeah.
Like a hoop, and she wore glasses. And, oh, she didn't?
Well, she might have worn ears.
Over her ears? What do you mean?
No, ears. What? Reading glasses.
Reading glasses. And they were yellow. Yellow, and then the rest was just clear, right? Have you seen those on her? Yellow. Like, yellow around her ears. That's weird. Interesting. Cool. And she always bited her nails. She had really short, stubby nails. Is that right? She had no short nails, and she's just like, I want to adopt him, is what she said. She says, I want to adopt him to somebody. I don't know who is. Did she want to adopt your son or something like that? Or me?
She never actually got to meet my son.
Yeah.
The day I pulled the blog, I put him in the bed with her, and she held him up until I took him out, and after I took him out of the bed away from her, she took three breaths and passed away.
Oh my gosh. They keep on saying Keith, Keith, Keith. All of them say Keith for some reason. And
Keith would be my last memory.
Aw, that's so sweet. Aw.
She was crying too.
I'm gonna cry. You're so like, you got death beauty. You got death emotional provoking beauty, or a cosmic beautiful story. Mm-hmm. What an interesting tragedy. Oh my god. Did she throw up or like gargle something out of her mouth while she was dying or something like that?
Yeah, she had a
Like it was all like all out of her mouth. Like it's all this white foam and stuff coming out of her mouth. Do what?
She had a vent too.
Oh. Jeez. Oh. I can't believe it. She's like kicking up, kicking and stuff. I don't know.
Yeah, she was driving me.
Yeah, she was kicking. And
she tried to pull drain tubes that was in her wash to drain her wash of fluid. She's trying to pull them out with her feet.
Oh, you're right. Like, she couldn't use her hands or something.
They were tied down.
Yeah, that she was like, she could not move her hands, so she was kicking her freaking feet all over the place. And her bed was right next to the wall, probably next to the window or not, I'm not sure, but it's next to the wall.
Yeah, it was
on the right side, right? And so the left shoulder of her was facing the right side of her. Her left shoulder was facing, you know what I'm saying? So it's up in the corner, that's the bed. But she basically was drooling herself alone, and then someone came in there, or didn't, or something. They came in there and then they left her to die by herself, right?
No, she died. I was right there with her.
Okay. Yeah, some girl came in there, and I don't know, but you try to go get the doctor in, and you were in and out probably? Do what? Huh? You're breaking up. Sorry. Huh? Okay. Well, thank you.